गुड आफ्टरनून दलजीत मैम, कांशा मैम एंड ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. Just wait for a minute. We are starting with the class. We have completed the 10 questions from the exercise. 4 questions are left in this exercise. Okay, so let us start with this question, question number 11. A car has two wipers which do not overlap. Okay, suppose I am making one wiper which starts, suppose, from here and ends here, and it is making an angle of 115 degree. So the wiper sweeps the area which is making an angle of 115 degree. Then there is one more wiper there. It sweeps in the same manner with the same angle of 115 degree. Yes, good afternoon, all those who have come now. Concentrate here now on the question. So they're talking about two wipers of a car which do not overlap. Means the area cleaned by one wiper will not be cleaned by the other wiper, and both are making an angle of 115 degree. Find the total area cleaned at each sweep of the blade. Total area cleaned by each sweep of the blade. Okay. This right here, theta, which is given at 115 degree. This is area of sector formed by the, this is the sector which is formed by these blades while sweeping over the area. And where the radius, the length of the blade is given 25 centimeter. This blade also is 25 centimeter. And this is also 25 centimeter. So radius of the sector that is 25 centimeter. Now area cleaned by, this is total area cleaned by each sweep of the blade. that is 2 multiply the area of sector pi r square multiplied by theta upon 360. As there are two blades, so we have to multiply by 2. So 2 into 22 upon 7 into 25 into 25 into theta, that is 115 upon 360, which we can cut by 5, 23 and 72. With 2 we can cut more, 36. With 2 again we can cut 18. Now we should multiply. So 18 multiplied by this, and this is 11 into 23, that will be 253 into 625 upon 7 into 18, 126, I guess. So multiply them. 253 multiplied by 625, that is 158, 125. Centimeter square. This is a complete solution. Note it down. Kush is asking, sir, is it compulsory to make the figure in these questions? In some of the questions, it is necessary, where you have to explain with the help of figure. So, and make a habit of making figure in this chapter and the next chapter. Chapter number 12 and 13 needs figure. And even all geometry and measurement chapters need figures. And in a paper, there will be at the one question that they'll be asking. So in that one question, you should make the figure. And it is not necessary that you have to make figure with scale. If you are doing your questions in hurry, means you have lack of time, then you can make the way I'm making here. Without scale, no reduction of marks will be done by the teacher, the examiner. Yeah. Okay. Next, the 12th. And keep this in mind, your each and every subject notebook should be completed. It is 10th and internals are there of 5 marks for your notebook. 5 marks for notebook directed. It is prescribed in the, what we say, CBSE circular. Okay, it is written there. How there is distribution of marks of internal. Marks. Okay. Now, next question number 12. To warn ships for underwater rocks, a lighthouse spreads a red colored light over a sector of angle 80 degree to a distance of 16.5 kilometers. Find the area of the sea over which the ships are warned. So there's a lighthouse. Okay. Oh, I don't know how to make it, just making it. So suppose, see, we have not to make figure in this question. This is just to explain you. So lighthouse is used to warn ships for underwater rocks that they are not able to see. Okay, so lighthouse used to spread light over a certain area. Okay, and this length of the this light which is going, that is 16.5 kilometer. And so it is making a sector of angle 80 degree as it is written here. So this 16.5 kilometer will be called as the radius of this sector. And this is the theta that is given, means angle is given 80 degree. So with the help of theta 80 and r 16.5, we can calculate the area on which the ships are want, something like this. Okay. So theta is 80 degree, and R, which we have to consider. Okay, and radius being 16.5 kilometer. And area of the sea over which ships are wound that is pi r square into theta by 360. So 3.14 as it is written in the question, then R is 16.5 into 16.5 into theta, that is 80 by 360. So by 2 we can cut 1.57 and this 18. Now let us multiply 1.57 into 16.5 into 16.5. It will be 4743. Pi r square theta by 360. We can cut this also. 2 4s are 2 9, and with 3 also we can cut. 3 3s are 3 5s are 15.5, then again with 3 5s are 15.5. So 1.57 just you have to multiply with 5.5 and 5.5 and 4. So answer is 189.97. it is in kilometer square. Note it down. So in these questions, no, they are all making sectors, and so we are using the formula of area of sector, and according to the angle, we are using the formula of area of minor sector. Done. Next question, 13. A round table cover has 6 equal designs. For example, like this, Khush, you were asking, Ankur, in this type of questions, you have to make, you should make figures where there is an explanation with figures. It is compulsory in this. So make this figure, and where this is a shaded region, and radius of the cover is 28 centimeter. So I am joining with all these points. As it is written that the round table cover has 6 equal designs. So these all designs, the side designs are equal. It means these sectors are also equal. And if these sectors are equal, then these angles will also be equal. Okay. Since table cover, let's write the solution. Since table cover has six equal designs so it has six it has six equal sectors, or if you don't want to go by this, just we can write that it has six equal sectors. So here theta will be equal to 360. 360 is the complete angle divided by 6. Here theta will be considered as 60 degree. Just consider now one sector. So this is one sector where the angle is 60 degree. And this design, how we can calculate this design? This which I have shaded with red. So this design is just a minor segment. So we have to use here the formula of minor segment. If you will be able to calculate the area of one minor segment, then you have to multiply by 6, because there are 6 designs in this way. And these all designs are minor segment. This and the same here. These all are minor segment. So here theta will be 60 degree. And R is given 28 centimeter. Find the cost of making these designs. So first of all, we should calculate the area of these 6 designs. So area of 6 designs is equals to, no, Ankur, we are not subtracting triangle. Yesterday I have told you the formula of area of minor segment that you can use directly. Area of 6 design is equals to 6 multiplied 6. We are multiplying because there are 6 designs. Multiply by area of minor segment. That is R square pi theta by 360 minus 1 by 2 sine theta. 6 multiply R square. Here R is 28. Then pi theta, pi we have to use 22 by 7. Multiply theta is 60 upon 360 minus 1 by 2 sine 60. So 6 multiply by 28 square, 784. Then cut this 6, then 2, 11, 2, 3. And it is 11 by 21 minus 1 by 2 into root 3 by 2. Now root 3 value is given in the question, that is 1.7. So we'll use the same 1.7. Now after this, take LCM and solve. That is 84, 44 minus 35.7. Cross multiply by taking the LCM, 4704. Then subtract it, 8.3. On 84. You can cut this both. You'll get 56. Finally, you'll get 464.8 centimeter square is the area of 6 designs. Then cost of designs, it is given rupees 0.35 per centimeter square. So multiply with the area. Note it down. Now the next question. Note it down, be quick. 30 seconds. I'm giving you to note it down. Next question. Area of sector of angle P of a circle with radius R is, see, area of sector is pi r square into theta by 360. What is written, angle should be P. So in place of theta, we am writing P. And radius should be capital R square. So pi R square into P by 360. Is any of this answer, is any of the option is matching with this? P by 360 into pi R square. P by 360 into pi capital R square. Yes? Yeah, this is matching. Cut this to P by 360 to pi r square. So D is the answer. No, this is the answer. Not B, it is D. In D, if you will cut this 2 and 720, it is equal to P by 360 to pi r square. D is P by 720. Into 2 pi capital R square, 2 and this cancels out. So it is P by 360 into pi capital R square. So that's why this is the answer. Note it down. The exercise is over. It's starting the next exercise, which is based on again these formulas. But the next exercise is important as compared till now what we have done. And now, exercise 12.3, question number 1. try to see this figure carefully. What is given? Find the area of the shaded region. In this exercise, it is all about shaded region. Whatever is shaded here, we have to find the area of that. And if PQ is 24, where this PQ line is given, 24, and this PR is given 7. This PR is 9. We have to find the area of shaded region. And you know what is shaded in this? This region is shaded. Fine. Yeah, you're correct. This region is shaded. And one more thing, this is also shaded. See carefully, this is the blue part. Let me highlight it. This part is also shaded. Okay, so see now. As we know that we have studied in ninth, angle in semicircle is 90 degree. Therefore, see this, QR is the diameter. QR is the diameter, and just see this side of QR. This is what? Semicircle, and see this angle. This angle. This is angle in semicircle. Angle in semicircle is 90 degree. The previous year concept, nothing new. Okay, so this angle is angle of 90. Therefore, angle P is 90 degree. If P is 90, then in triangle PQR, by Pythagoras theorem, H square is equal to P square plus B square. This we can use. Do you know why we are using this? To calculate the side RQ. Because RQ is the diameter of this circle. If we don't know the diameter, we'll not be able to know the radius. And we'll not be able to calculate this shaded region. Radius is compulsory to know. It is necessary in this question. So H square equals to P square plus B square, where this is 90. In front of 90, we have always H. So H is QR. NP, QP, and B is PR square. And QR, we don't know. QP, we know that is 24 square, and this is 7 square. And this is equal to 576 plus 49. So QR is equal to under root of 625. That is 25 centimeter. So diameter is, and radius in this is 25 by 2 centimeter. If it is clear till here, then just write area of shaded region. Now you have to think a little in this, how we can calculate the shaded region, area of shaded region. Shaded is this part and this little part. It means from semicircle we have to subtract. This is full semicircle. So first of all, I'm writing here, area of shaded region equals to area of semicircle minus area of triangle. This triangle we have to remove. Then we'll get the shaded region, and shaded is this only. This one. This and this little here. Okay. So this is shaded and this part is shaded. So from semicircle, we have to subtract this triangle. So area of semicircle minus area of triangle PQR. Note it down. Area of semicircle is pi r square by 2. And area of triangle is half into base into height. So pi being 22 by 7 into r. R is 25 by 2 into 25 by 2. And here we have one more to add down. So that also we should write like this, 1 by 2. Then minus 1 by 2 into base. Base is 7 and height is 24. With 2 and this cancels out. 2 and this also cancels out. Here we have 625 into 11 upon 28 minus 84. So it is 5, 7, 8, 6 upon 28 minus 84. 84 into 28, 2352. Six eight seven five minus 2352 upon 28. Subtract them. 4523 upon 28 centimeter square. Note it down. Be quick. Area of semicircle minus area of triangle PQR. First of all, we have calculated angle P 90. Then by Pythagoras, we have calculated QR. Then we got radius. Then area of shaded region. Just we have used this formula of semicircle and area of triangle. We have to subtract these two to get the answer. It is 4523. Now, next question. Find the area of shaded region. See this here, the shade is here only. If the radius of two concentric circles, radius of this circle is given 7 and radius of the bigger circle is given 14. So this is 7 from here to here. So see this, from here to here it is 7 because radius of the smaller circle is 7 and from here to here full, it is 14 centimeter. Okay, means AO is 14. See this, if you see this thing, that this is a sector, fine, of the smaller circle. And this being the sector of the bigger circle, the outer circle. So area of bigger sector, see area of bigger sector minus area of smaller sector. So this we have to subtract from the bigger one. Okay. So let us start. It's all simple. Just write, always write no smaller radius by small r and capital radius by capital R. Radius of sector BOD. That is represented by small r and this is 7 centimeter. In the same way, radius of sector of circle AOC, that is represented as capital R, 14 centimeter. Now, area of shaded region is equal to area of sector AOC minus area of sector BOD. So area of sector AOC pi r square theta by 360 minus pi small r square theta by 360. So there is a difference of only capital R and small r. So we can take pi theta by 360 common because it is same in both cases. Here we are left with r and here also with r square. So pi we can use the value 22/7 and theta is clearly given 40 degree. Then capital R means 14 square minus 7 square. This and this cancels out, 4 and this cancels out. Now it is 22/63 and 196 minus 49. So 22/63 into subtract this 196 and 49, we'll get 147. So cut this by 7. 721, 7 9s are, 3 3s are, 3 7s are. So it is 154/3 cm². Note, and in this way, we have the next question, which you have to try. It is for your homework. Try question number 3 by your own. Otherwise, we'll discuss it tomorrow, question number 3. Okay, no worries at all. Note down this solution and the class is over. Rest we'll discuss tomorrow. Try to do the third question also in your notebook. Area of square minus area of two semicircles. This only we have to use in this. Okay, bye. Take care.